You're listening to the Quint podcast.
पोल्यूशन बहुत ज़्यादा है जिसकी वजह से आंखों में जलन है तकलीफ है और सांस लेने में दिक्कत हो रही है सांस लेने पर जो है गले में जलन और दर्द हो रहा
Why has Delhi turned into a gas chamber? I'm not talking about the abstract conceptual why. I mean literally why has Delhi turned into a cocktail of poisonous fumes that kills people with every breath they take? Is Delhi's air pollution, which crossed 10 times the safe limit over the past 2 weeks, caused by vehicular emissions, stubble burning, fireworks, industrial emissions, or something more sinister? Hello and welcome back to another episode of the Big Story podcast, where we dissect headline-making news. I'm your host, Vishnu Gopinath. This is the second part of a two-part podcast on Delhi's pollution crisis. In the first part, we took a look at what's causing the dangerous levels of pollution, a brief look, what harm it can do, what steps have been taken to check it, and most importantly, how we can protect ourselves from the pollution. In the second part, we explored the causes closer. Is stubble burning the real cause? Is it the fireworks that were bursted on Diwali? Industrial emissions? And what can we do, if anything, to reduce pollution? I'm joined on this episode by Dr. Anumita Roychowdhury.
Agriculture stubble burning, which happens only for about a month around this time, its contribution is hugely variable.
She's the Executive Director for Research and Advocacy at the Center for Science and Environment. I'm also joined by Dr. Santosh Harish, who works with the Center for Policy Research.
They contribute throughout the year and they contribute to the secondary particulate matter formation.
And agriculture expert Devinder Sharma.
You can always pass on the blame to farmers. It looks very nice because people in Delhi don't want to make any sacrifice as for their own lives.
Now, Delhi's pollution levels are sky high. Air that measures 300 plus on the air quality index is severely harmful to all people. Delhi's air was twice that number in many areas and more than six times that number in parts of Delhi starting 26th October. Pollution levels began to skyrocket post Diwali. So the first thing to get the blame for the pollution was obviously people bursting fireworks on Diwali. And for a while now that's been the case. Diwali rolls around and despite stricter regulations on bursting fireworks, including limits on bursting them between 8 p.m. and 10 p.m, fireworks continue to be burst well beyond this time on Diwali. Now, how much does bursting fireworks contribute to pollution? A report from the Center for Science and Environment analyzed real-time data from Delhi NCR and found that PM2.5 concentrations, aka the metric we use to measure pollution, jumped by approximately tenfold in the hours immediately after Diwali. So, I asked Dr. Anumita Roychowdhury. She is the Executive Director for Research and Advocacy at the Center for Science and Environment.
So the way you really need to understand this is that this is really part of the winter smog problem. So the way this smog episode happened, so Diwali night was when Delhi got its first severe pollution.
Want to hear the rest of this podcast? Check out the link to the full episode in the description below and follow The Quint on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, JioSaavn, and all other platforms we are on.